Hi, this is Graham from Jenham's Astro. Today we're going to try something a little bit different. We're going to try to photograph the International Space Station passing in front of the Sun.
So this is the setup we're going to use. We've got my Celestron C90 Maxitov. On the front we've got a white light solar filter, which is made from Barda solar film. I've got the scope on top of an equatorial mount, though I suppose it's possibly optional. You can do this with an altazimuth mount. And I've got a Canon digital DSLR. And according to a couple of the online apps, Transit Finder and Cow Sky, there's a predicted transit of the space station in front of the Sun in around half an hour, and I'm going to try to capture it on video.
Okay, so before we have a go at trying to photograph the transit, just a quick recap on using one of these programs. So I'm using transitfinder.com. And you go onto the web page, and basically you tell the app where you are in the world. So you can select that from a map, or it can auto detect your location. If you use this on your phone, for example, if location services are enabled. So save and close your location. Specify a range of dates that you're interested in, that you want to know future transits and close passes of the Sun and the Moon. And then you specify if you are willing to travel a certain distance from your location, you can type that value in as well and press calculate. And the app goes away and comes back with a series of future solar close passes and transits, and the same for the Moon. And for each one, you get all the vital information you need. You get the exact time when the transit's going to occur, which is very important for the space station because they're always very short, and the direction you're going to see the transit and the time that it will take for the space station to cross the Sun or the Moon. So you can look forward, plan a little bit, and find the best potential transit for your location and get set up in advance. It's a really good app. I recommend you have a look and see what it says for your location.
So aside from the scope and the camera, etc., what else do you need to capture a solar transit? Well, the most important thing is an accurate clock. The transit's going to take a very short period of time, and unlike a transit in front of the Moon, where you can see the bright space station approaching the Moon, in the case of the Sun, it's all going to be over very quickly, and you won't get much warning except for having an accurate grip on the time. So I've compared the online apps. They both agree to within 1 second of the time when the transit will occur. And I've got a clock which I believe is accurate. And we're going to give it a go. I'm going to use video to bracket the exposure in the hope that there's an increased chance of capturing the transit. 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
No,
yeah.
I didn't.
Okay, so in case you missed that, let's have another look. So this time, playing the video at 1/4 of its actual speed, and you can see the space station transiting across the disk. After taking the video, I've then extracted a few frames at 0.2 seconds apart, and I've stacked them into this mosaic, which shows you, I think, quite a nice picture of the transit. And then finally, a close-up of that picture, you can just about see the solar arrays sticking out on either end of the space station. Pretty happy with that. So overall, I'd say give this a try. Definitely worth a go. Have a look at one of those transit apps and just make sure you're prepared, because this will happen very rapidly. You've got to get all your focusing sorted out before the transit occurs. Okay, thanks for watching.